Yes, Business Live Global. Hello. It is I, Johnny Boy, the consumer monkey McDonald, here with yet another interview with a business person, a mover, a shaker, a charity, a paradigm shifter. Who knows who will be on? It's always going to be interesting and it's always going to be varied. And if you think you've got some added value for the Business Live community, which is now, it's occurring in 5 countries live, and we are internationally through our online events. Join us today and put yourself forward for an interview where you get to choose the questions I ask, and not only that, but you get to choose a favourite song of yours as well. So it's all win-win. So let's see who we've got in the room for today. Are you a budding author, an author, or an entrepreneur? You need to speak to this guy. I give you Marco Bonanni. Marco, hello.
Hi, thanks for having me on the show today. I want to introduce myself really quickly here. Speaking as an author and as an entrepreneur, if you've been through the journey as long as I have, hit rock bottom a few times, you'll definitely be interested in the content that I have prepared and can share with you today.
Very nice, very nice. What are some of the things that make you who you are today?
I've been through a lot of ups and downs. I'm very persistent. I'm open to learning, and I'm open to sharing and helping other people. So the stuff that I learn, I put into practice, and then after I've practiced it enough times, I'm able to share it and help other people with it.
Very good, very good. I've read a number of the books that you also promote. So can you share some key principles or strategies from your book that can help individuals improve their productivity?
Sure. So in Success Secrets, the book that I authored a couple of years ago, I dive into the importance of effective task prioritization, time management, and harnessing the power of focus to enhance productivity. My book provides actionable techniques and strategies that individuals can implement in their daily lives to optimize their workflow and achieve greater efficiency. So when it comes to task prioritization, in Success Secrets, I offer insights into identifying and focusing on high priority tasks that align with your goals and objectives. I emphasize the significance of allocating time and energy to activities that have the greatest impact on your personal and professional growth. Mm-hmm. My book explores various time management strategies that help individuals make the most of their available time. It addresses the challenges of multitasking, procrastination, and distractions, and offers practical tips for effective time allocation, scheduling, and creating productive routines.
What can you give me an example of one of those practical tips?
Sure. So another key aspect that I discuss in Success Secrets is the power of focus. My book emphasizes the need to cultivate concentration and eliminate distractions to achieve deep work and optimal performance. Provide techniques for improving concentration, such as mindfulness practices and creating an environment that is conducive to focused work. So implementing these techniques in my book from Success Secrets, individuals can enhance their productivity by effectively prioritizing tasks, managing time, and on owning their ability to concentrate. So these actionable strategies enable readers to achieve more in less time and make significant progress towards their goals.
Okay, so look, I'm thinking that from an entrepreneur's perspective, certainly, and we'll look at this in a moment, from an entrepreneur's mm-hmm. perspective, becoming more efficient, prioritizing tasks and the tools they need to do that, perfect sense. People mm-hmm. employed in corporate America, corporate Canada, corporate UK are mm-hmm. on 0 hours contracts. They've had their benefits removed. They don't really care. About 90% of people say that, so they're not engaged in their work. So what's the point of doing this for those people who definitely need the help?
So I don't differentiate between, like, as an entrepreneur or if your career on your if you're on your career path, you really need to apply the same principles.
Go
Whether
on.
you're working towards career growth or personal entrepreneurial growth, it's really very similar. You want to be implementing all of these techniques regardless of what you're working on, even if it's your health or fitness. Progress, they're really very much overlapping techniques and processes that you should be following.
And you've walked the talk. Can you, do you mind elaborating
You
on that at
know,
all?
absolutely. So, I mean, my personal story goes way back, but for the most recent one, and I always describe this as like the stock market chart. You know, your life is like the stock market chart. You go up and down, and when we have a downfall, it always feels like a huge stock market crash. But if you were actually to zoom out and peer at it from a distance, you'd just see that it's just a small downturn. And when we experience those downturns, a lot of times we think that it's, you know, detrimental or very, very catastrophic. And that's usually when we open up our minds the most and are open to learning and growing. And so those are important times in our lives when we can take advantage of to actually become more open-minded to changing and improving ourselves. And that's really what happened to me. So I went through this process. I describe a lot more of the steps or what happened to me in my book, Success Secrets, and how you can use the techniques and strategies that I learned. And I've read over 70 books in 2020, and I go into details of how I reached that objective and goal. It really started out with making some small changes, and those small changes sort of compound and snowball, and eventually leads to a huge success. So that compounding effect is really important, and sometimes taking that first initial step is really where it starts the journey. But that initial step sometimes isn't really that motivating until you've gone through something that really encourages you or motivates you to start.
I it sounds like you're describing what some people would call as trauma.
You know, at times when you're going through that downturn, it does feel like so traumatic, and you don't want to be there.
I only mention because I've been on my own journey, which we won't talk about today, but the greatest learnings and the ability to step back from your own thinking, as you describe, is something I have noticed that is most key with people that have gone through or are aware that they've gone through trauma, if they had to work their brain around it. So
Yes.
listen, I know that your business helps authors, but can you elaborate on the significance of joining a mastermind group as you discuss in your book?
Yeah, absolutely. I always find value in surrounding yourself with like-minded individuals, such as a mastermind group. A mastermind group is more of a diluted version of working with a coach or a mentor. Sometimes having a high-quality coach or mentor, you know, can be outside of your budget range. And so, working in a mastermind group, you get a chance to sort of dilute the cost, and then sharing ideas. I always find that super valuable. If you read any of the success books that I list in my book, or the books that I've read, they all of the super successful people were all part of a mastermind group. And so, if you see any depth into that, you'll understand the value and importance of being in a mastermind group. And so that was one of the motivations for me to start my mastermind group called Tappreneur, which I mentioned in my book as well,
What's it
is to
called again?
bring Tappreneur. So it's kind of a spin-off entrepreneur and the part of my company called Tapnet. You know, I created that just to invite other people that are interested in, you know, looking for a place where they can share ideas. And the tagline for my group is called Ask, Learn, and Share. So we invite you to come in, ask questions about your journey, where you're stuck, and then learn from the others that are in the group, and then share when you've reached a point where you know, learned and can provide and give back.
Sounds excellent. So someone listening to this interview right now today, who do you want to speak to? Talk to them.
Yeah, so regardless of what your goals and objectives are, I think we are all on a journey to move forward. So if you're starting a small business or an entrepreneur, that's really the typical audience that I really can talk to the best, because that's the journey that I'm on. And I like to, how does that saying go? Walk the talk.
I think it is walk the talk.
Walk the talk. So I do and teach what I do. So I don't want to, you know, teach something that I'm not familiar with or don't have any experience in. So I'm on that journey. If you're an entrepreneur, if you're starting a small business, if you're running a side hustle and you're stuck, you need some help moving forward, need to learn how to set some goals and start with my book. It's a great compilation of the lessons that I've learned over the last few years. And then once you've digested that, you can move on to the next step. And I've created a path called Success Secrets that you can follow. It's a template that teaches you the steps that I followed to become more productive and achieve my goals faster. And you can do the same.
Excellent. Right. So they should reach out to you. I know that people on LinkedIn definitely could use what you're offering. We've chosen a song that was from my youth, as it is from yours, Eye of the Tiger by Survivor. So enjoy this. And Marco, thank you for your time.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Okay.